And welcome to Neutral Site Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. And the fans are on their feet awaiting the start of this game as the players line up for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Well, here comes the guy that we've all been waiting for, our player to watch this game. Murray's vision, his patience, Kirk behind center, really makes him a complete player.
And Brad, both of those attributes are especially important anytime you're out on the road and you're playing in a hostile environment. This kid is really cool under pressure, and no matter how loud this crowd's going to get today, I don't think he's going to have much of a problem of blocking them out and playing his game.
Second and one. Ball on their own 34. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Pretty good gain on the play by the halfback.
If you can consistently get 4 or 5 yards at a pop, you know that you're going to have a functioning offense.
Got it, and brought down immediately.
Number 33 makes the tackle at the 44-yard line.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. Knocked out of bounds at the 24.
Well, I tell you, these guys have some skill players who can make things happen. They picked up an enormous amount of real estate on that play.
So after the big pass play, we've got a first down. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That'll make it second and four.
They come out on an empty backfield. Throws it in a hurry. And he's tackled at the 5.
This passing game can be very effective if you don't get enough pressure on the quarterback. They use their personnel well and can be very tough to defend.
First and goal from the 5, and looking to cap this off with a touchdown. Marshall, the ball carrier, and he makes it out to about the 5-yard line. Here's the 8th play of the series. They've got their goal line sets on the field. This might be a good time for play action. Heading for the corner. Touchdown, Georgia! Strong run by the halfback to get into the end zone.
He's a pretty sure bet to get 6 when you're this close to the end zone.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. An 8-play, 74-yard drive. And the result, 7 points. Georgia gets set to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. He gets rid of this one.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
From their own 25-yard line. Second down. He's taken down at the 44-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
He's got room to run. They'll bring him down right around the 48-yard line. 8 yards.
That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Up the middle for a nice game. Carries the ball for a nice game.
That'll bring up second and three.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Runs left and can't get back to the line of scrimmage.
No gain. That makes it third and three.
Caught with room to work. He's tackled around the 18-yard line.
When they broke the huddle, I'm sure everybody knew the ball was going to go to this receiver. And he still brought it in to give this team a big lift.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 18. To about the 17-yard line. Pickup of a yard for the tailback.
We've watched this guy play, and over the course of his college career, he's made some spectacular tackles. Nice play.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. He's got the corner. Got an opening. Touchdown, tie.
This guy seems to make things happen no matter what kind of space he has to work with. All he needs is a little crease of daylight and forget about it.
The extra point to tie this game up. And he converts the extra point. Foster has the ball set and he looks ready to kick this one deep. He just drills this one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. Gets it out quick, and it's going the other way.
I really like this corner's ability to read the play. He shows very good football smarts and pretty good hands, too.
From the 38-yard line, first down. Tackle made at the 41.
The defense was playing run all the way right there, and it paid off for him.
That brings up second and 13.
Decides to slide. McCarron picks up about 4 yards after pulling the ball down and scrambling there.
That'll make it third.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 28. Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. Tackle at the 29.
That was a well-designed and executed pattern, but on third down and forever, it just wasn't enough.
Quick throw, and down he goes at the 24-yard line. We've played one quarter. We get a tie game at 7-7. We can only hope the second quarter is as good as the first. Tight ball game, folks. Tackle outside after a nice pickup.
Gain of 5 on the play. it second and four.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Here comes the pressure, and they bring him down for a sack on the play.
Loss of 6 yards on the play. That makes it third and 11.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Screen pass. He's got his half back. They'll drop him for a loss.
That was a loss of 1 yard on the play. That makes it fourth and 12.
It looks like they're going to try for the long field goal. Alabama could take the lead with this field goal. The kick is up, and it's good.
Boy, he had plenty of distance there and pushed it through. Very impressive leg strength.
10-7, Alabama. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20, and down he goes at the 26-yard line. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Man can't tack on any yardage.
Number 13 makes the tackle at the 31-yard line. That brings up second and 5.
From their own 31-yard line, second down.
Ready. Flag on the 8. Flag on the 8.
He gets to about the 41-yard line.
Just a simple draw play there, but they picked up some big yards.
First down.
And he's going to be sacked.
Boy, Brad, that was a big hit on the quarterback. I'm going to be interested to see how he responds from this hit and whether or not he comes after his offensive lineman and challenges them to start playing a little bit better.
So the sack makes this a second and long.
Yeah. You don't want nothing. Hey, check by 33. Check by 33.
And he just gets rid of it. Him hard at the 23.
That is a loss of 11 yards on the play. That makes it fourth and 9.
The sack makes this a fourth and very long. Jones will be the return man. Jones takes it at the 33, brought down at the 38-yard line. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Alabama holds a field goal lead. Fakes the handoff, defense coming. Finds his man, and they take him down immediately. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Makes the grab, and he's got the first. Brought down right around the 42-yard line. Tackles him hard at the 48.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
And he's taken down right around the 38-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 32. And they make the stop at the 21. Throws it away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Makes the catch and look out. And he's tackled right around the 12-yard line. So we're looking at another third down here. Alabama is up by three. Looks for the tight end, but they can't hook up.
I'm not so sure he made the best decision that time. That was a pretty tight area he was trying to throw that one into.
And he's going to be sacked for a loss. So they turn it over on downs, and that's a big boost for this defense.
In a close game like this one, it's big plays like this that can be the deciding factor.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. Out of bounds at the 23-yard line.
6 yards. That brings up second and five.
It's second and five here. Ball on the 23. Got a man wide open, and it goes through his hands. It out to about the 24-yard line. Alabama is going to have to use their second time out of the half. Barber is the punter. He wasn't breaking that tackle. What a hit. Well, it's always fun to be part of a defensive battle, and that's certainly what we have right now.
Yeah, give credit to both of these defenses. I mean, they're playing with a lot of energy, and I think they're doing a nice job up front at the line of scrimmage. And at this point, they're not giving either of these offenses a chance to make a play.
Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He's taken down at about the 45.
Makes it second and six.
Alabama is up a field goal. He rifles it. And he's got his receiver. It's the sophomore. They'll bring him down right around the 14-yard line. He throws. Almost intercepted in the end zone.
And you can see he made a great move here, anticipating the football. He came up with a big defensive play.
From the 14-yard line, it's second down. Fires it out. He's tackled at the six. Alabama's out of timeouts. It's up, and it's good.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
They can take a halftime lead by taking this one all the way back, folks. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. So at the end of the half, Alabama leads it 13-7.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half.
Neither ground game got much going in the first half, averaging a little less than 3 yards per rush. David, as you look at this, look, you always hear the term, get the offense behind the chain.
Oh, yeah.
You get them in long yardage situations. What does that do for a defense?
Well, it's so much fun. You start with a defensive line, you know it's a pass. You get to fly upfield as fast as you want to. It's not third and three where you're sitting in a situation where they could run or they could pass, and there's a little bit of doubt in your mind when you're coming. You fly upfield, you rush the passer. Everybody knows that the sticks are a little bit further back, so DBs can back up a little bit and play to the sticks as opposed to playing third and short situations. It makes it easier on a whole defense.
That's it for us here in the studio. What are you going to do in the second half while the game's going on?
Yeah, I'm
going
to kick back and watch all these monitors.
We'll keep you up to date on everything going on around the country right now. Time for the second half with Brad and Kirk.
Very close game now as we start the second half. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again. Alabama up six. Gives it to the back. That's a great tackle at the 34-yard line. Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. He's hit and taken down. White picks up about 5 yards on that hookup.
And I like the decision the quarterback made on this play. He didn't try to force a deep pass. Instead, he just threw a little dump-off pass that was good enough for a first down.
Gets out to about the 42-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That makes it second and eight.
It's second down, 8 to go. Ball on their own 42. Fires out to his receiver. Tackle made around the 49-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 37-yard line. And he makes it out to about the 34-yard line.
That'll make it second and seven.
Hit hard.
Gain of 6 on the play. That'll bring up third and inches.
So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down.
Two down.
Alabama is up by 6. Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
False start, offense.
It'll be third down again after that penalty.
Yeah, now they have more yards still to pick up for the first down.
Down grab, tailback has it, and that sets them up with a first and goal.
That's a gain of 23 on the play. That makes it first and goal.
It's the ninth play of the drive. And he throws it away. From the 10-yard line, it's second down. They'll spread the field with five wide. Looks to the receiver, touchdown.
This team has so many potent weapons. It's tough to try to single out just one of them to stop.
And he hits the PAT. A 10-play, 79-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. The score now, 20-7. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Alabama's continuing to play extremely tough defense. This has been impressive.
It's just been impressive to watch them play with such an attitude, almost a chip on their shoulder with the energy that they're playing with. I think it's going to require that kind of effort to be able to win this game.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Nice gain of around 7 yards on that delay.
That'll bring up second and three.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. And down he goes at the 34.
Call it a gain of 2 yards. That'll make it third and one.
Tight end left, tight end left. Three down. Check back.
Up the middle for a nice game.
Call it again with 5 yards. First down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 39. Throws this one away. And here's a quick throw. And he got it! The 10. He's all the way home. Touchdown. Nicely designed play to the wide receiver, and it got him 6.
You said it, Brad, and a good time to call it. I tip my hat to the offensive coordinator.
Boy, that was an easy throw for the quarterback. Had to be a mistake of some kind or miscommunication by the defense in that secondary, but the quarterback finds his receiver wide open for the touchdown.
The extra point. It was a 5-play, 75-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
He's to the 20. Tackle made at the 30. Man, both offenses here in this third quarter have been on fire. Time for the defense to step to the forefront a little bit.
Makes you wonder which of these defenses has the ability to come up and make a stop. It could be one of those games where whichever defense comes up with that stop could be the team that wins the game. Last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy, or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game?
Gets out to about the 31.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That makes it second and 10.
From their own 31-yard line, second down. Alabama with a 6-point lead. Can't get away from the pressure.
Loss of 5 yards on the play. That brings up third and 14.
They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a five wide outlook. Fires out to his wide out. And he's level at the 41-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
From their own 41-yard line, first down. Quick throw, brought down at the 49.
That's a gain of 8 on the play. That makes it second and 2.
Double tight, guys, double tight. Down, down. Right 55, right 55.
He gets rid of this one. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. It fly. What a pick. And there isn't anyone who's going to catch this cornerback.
Number 5 with the interception.
The pressure definitely got to the quarterback there because that pass was not on target.
The defense was just sitting on that. They were in zone coverage. As soon as they saw he was in trouble, they were all over the football.
From their own 46-yard line, it's first down. They'll get him for a loss. A great game so far, and it looks like it'll be decided in the fourth. 2014, Crimson Tide. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number 4. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense.
That's a gain of 5 on the play. That'll make it 3rd and 9.
Third and long here. Let's see what the offensive coordinators come up with. And this quarterback needs a conversion here. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. And they make the stop around the 41-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 12 yards. First down.
Hey, watch 11, watch 11. Focus, defense, focus.
Gets it out quickly. He's out of bounds around the 33-yard line. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. And he's met immediately.
That is a loss of 5 on the play. That makes it 4-7.
And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this 5-receiver look. Quick pass. And he's tackled right around the 32-yard line. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. Taken down around the 30-yard line.
The offensive coordinator has to be elated with the way his offense right now is executing. They're not in a hurry, but they're very, very methodical and very consistent with their approach. That's a third first down that they've picked up on this drive.
Tipped away.
You know, for you young cornerbacks and young defensive backs, this is a great example of just being smart and efficient as a defender. Instead of taking a chance and going for that interception, he was smart. Got in position, knocked the football away, and didn't give the receiver a chance to make a play on the football.
Sets up a screen, tailback's got it, and he shoved out of bounds at the 29. To get back in this game in the fourth quarter, this third and long is huge.
G26, G26, let's go!
incomplete. He's down. Less than 3 minutes in the game. On the run, and the defense will hold. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Gains his way to the 36-yard line. From their own 36-yard line, first down.
Passes are going to help the quarterback's confidence.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. He's taken down at the 29-yard line. Georgia will have one timeout remaining. Georgia's called their final timeout. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Nice run there.
I think the defense put everything into that sequence of plays, and for the offense to come up with a first down really is demoralizing for the defense.
Back with a carry. He's pushed out of bounds at the 10. From the 10-yard line, second down. Puts on a move, touchdown. With that score, now it's up to the defense, and they're well aware that maybe one stop and they've got a victory. And the quarterback stays on the field as they try for the two-point conversion. They don't get it, and they get the two. A nice seven-play, 77-yard drive, and they come away with 8 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So our score, 28-14. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Alabama's defense has really been impressive, especially these last couple of drives.
Well, now you start to think about how this team has played defensively, and what it's done is set up their own offense with really good field position to give them a chance to be able to extend this lead.
And he throws right away. And it's caught at the 30 for the 20. And a huge touchdown play. Tacks on the extra point. Brought down at the 43.
Covers the onside kick.
They punched it in for six on the last series. Can they do it again?
Well, I think this defense has got to do something, because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
From the 45-yard line, it's second down. Makes it to the 34. So this one's in the books, and we saw a great one here today. 28-21, Alabama. The Bulldogs. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you.